independent variable, that's probably what he was thinking. But I asked you to graph it this way, so I get my slope a certain way. So that'll be okay. And especially if you, I think that would assume a lot of them were the wrong way. I didn't really forget that. But yeah, voltage, water, independent variable, technically. But if you graph it like this, our slope ends up being a certain term that I wanted it to be. And so it's still fine. As long as the main thing here in this graph is what kind of shape. Then you wanted to see that the voltage and the current were in linear. But either way you graph that, it's the same thing. Now in this case, Ryan's slope was 10. And you know what the resistance of the object you were graphing about was?
Nothing.
Did you change, well, it was something, it was like a resistor? Did you change the default value?
No.
Good, so the resistor that Ryan was graphing over was a 10 ohm light bulb, which is the same as his slope. So what does the slope of that graph tell me?
It's ohms.
We don't talk about units, we talk about the name.
It's
resistance. And so what we know then is that the, let's go back to our other little program. So, the resistance so we know the resistance of our light bulb, or whatever it is going to be the slope of the graph. What would the equation for the slope of that graph we looked at be? What was the y-axis? Voltage. So it'd be potential difference divided by the current. Yay. We're amazing. So that is resistance equals voltage over current. This is what we'll refer to as Ohm's law. And it's really probably the most important equation we'll use this chapter. One thing that's a little confusing is not really a law. There's times where it doesn't work, but substantially it works in all cases. There'll be two cases in particular we'll discuss where it doesn't work. We'll discuss like either tomorrow or on the Thursday, you know, we'll wrap just to prove that it's not always going to be true. But for our purposes, it's always going to be true when we're doing our math. This will explain for us voltage, the potential difference, the current, and the resistance are the three most important terms that we want to know at any object at any time, and just relate to those three terms. Very often, I'll write it as V equals I times R, so that's the way I typically think of it when I think of Ohm's law, but that's just a matter of rearranging it. And your book claims that the most logical way to write it would be that I equals V over R, and they claim that because they want you to think about current. It's probably the most important one of the terms to think about, or the easiest term to think about, is current or the speed of the charges. And so basically, you know, if there's more resistance, this current's gonna get smaller. If it's taking up more energy, it means the current will probably go running faster. So this, I guess, their opinion is the most logical way to think about that current. So there's Ohm's law, very important one. Question? That was exciting. Okay, any questions on Ohm's law? I'd like to talk to you for a minute about resistance. So we're gonna set that up here. It's my portable keyboard right now. And so what does a resistor do for me? There's two or three things a resistor does for me. Anyone know what they are? Yes, sir? So ultimately, we're going to say resistor slows down the charging, slows down the current. How does the resistor slow down the charging? What specifically is it doing that makes the charging go forward? Noises? It could, in one sense, we can say it's going to change the collisions. We're going to maybe increase or decrease the collision based upon how carbon material is. And so the other thing I would say to you, we haven't talked about, is the resistor really what it does technically is it takes energy out of the circuit. And so that's really the biggest thing that it does, and that causes, as a result of other things that we just talked about. It takes it out by having more collisions. We have more collisions, and or more or less collisions, that's going to change my energy. That kind of goes back to, remember back to your good friend, the drinking bird, and those types of things. know that collisions cause a transfer of energy. And so the more times that particle has to collide, the more energy it's going to lose. And we take energy out of the circuit, that's going to cause it to slow down. So that's the basic thing where a resistor does. Are there any common examples of resistors? Or everything is basically a resistor in life. Everything in a, every object in a circuit takes energy out of the circuit somehow. And so, as an example, the biggest place we lose energy in this country, and probably all countries, in our energy system is the process of getting energy from the power plant to our house. So it goes through the wires, that's where you're going to lose a lot of energy to just the distance power on that path. If you get rid of that energy loss, you have a lot less energy problems in the country. You can lose power on that path. So that's a bad example of resistance. What are some good examples, not good and bad, incorrect words, what are some useful examples of the very good. A volume knob would be one example of that. What other examples are there? Tim, do you have another one? A toaster, very good. So there's some, maybe there's some pictures of it. You know, they're cheating there. But we have some pictures here from your books. They may have made the, read the book. Well, right, so basically anything that gets hot is a pretty big resistor. And so a toaster, for example, we heat up these little wires in the toaster, they get hot and they can spread the resistance. A volume knob on a stereo is a variable resistor. As you increase the volume, that actually decreases the resistance in the circuit, which lets the current flow faster, it makes the volume louder. A light bulb is the same idea as a toaster, but it's encased in a vacuum, so it glows for the bright light and those sorts of things. Sometimes we'll just want to reduce the resistance without actually doing anything, and that would be a case like maybe your clock radio only need 9 volts of energy to work, right? That might be the case in most of these 9-volt areas where you stay out of power load off, and you put it in the question that. And so, what annual voltage comes out of our walls? 120 volts come out of your wall, and so if your clock radio only needs 9 volts, somehow we need to reduce that down by 111 volts, right? Otherwise, clock radio can hold the heat melt. And that's where you would just, in your clock radio circuit, put a resistor. And that's going to just decrease the voltage going into your clock radio. There might be several resistors to do that, so they don't hold the heat itself. But this is just a resistor. You might use this circuit to build it, effect in the box that you both want to do something to not steal them. But this little guy here just produces a difference. They're all the same size, basically, so I believe just the different materials inside of there are causing different levels of resistance. So a box going this way has 56,000 ohms of resistance, a box has 12,000 ohms. And so you have a wide range of value of resistance to the same amount of energy for doing different kind of the circuit. And so if you're opened up an appliance before, look inside of it, you might see it look like this, but it just simply will take away energy for the food that you're eating. Yeah, but this thing is designed to take that heat without a stir. So you're trying to protect the other parts of the circuit. You're trying to protect the LED on the radio face, you might only want 1 volt in order to actually turn red and shift over time. And so you want to protect that with all the ones that you want. They're designed, and that's why I think you might use several of them. So if this is all by itself, it might get really hot. And I've done it before in the lab, and too much energy through a resistor, it's just kind of smoke or whatever else. So you might need like 5 of these resistors in a row. Each of these are only so much heat tolerance. Yeah. And so you want to line 5 of them up in a row to take away some energy. That's what we do the whole circuit. Yeah. So is your though. Yeah, it's pretty small, but not that. Questions about, so you can look at Bill as they come around there. It's done in there about things. Questions about resistors or Ohm's law right now? Do you think that wires have resistance.